This is p53. It's a tumour-suppressing protein found in cells throughout the body. Also known as the guardian of the genome. On a good day, it's all that stands in the way of a dizzying array of cancers. And in the presence of cellular stressors, it jumps into action, with the ability to trigger DNA repair, halt cell division, or activate the cellular self-destruct mechanism, known as apoptosis. But when it stops working, damaged cells are given the green light to proliferate, with little treatment options to halt their spread. Scientists have been studying p53 for over 50 years. In fact, the gene which codes for the protein, called TP53, is actually the most widely researched gene in the human genome. P53-associated cancers remain difficult to treat. This is because traditional therapies actually rely on P53 to destroy cancerous cells damaged by radio or chemotherapy. Normally, this tumour-suppressing protein is found inactive inside the cell, and this occurs through the binding of a regulatory protein called MDM2. When a cell encounters stressful conditions, MDM2 is released, allowing P53 to be transported into the cell nucleus to save the day. Here, it assembles into a much larger four-molecule tetramer and binds with specific DNA sequences for gene regulation. The genes which are switched on by P53 are determined by the severity of stress. For example, mild stress may pause cell division for repair, while severe stress may activate cell death. Without the protection of functional P53, damaged cells can spread unchecked, leading to cancerous tumour growth. And this can arise through two mechanisms. The first is through a mutation of the TP53 gene, which leads to a faulty misfolded protein. The other instance is through an overabundance of MDM2, deactivating too much P53 in the cell. Although many are under development, there are still no effective catch-all treatments for P53-associated cancers. Promising strategies involve restoring activity of mutant P53, or reactivating P53 that is bound up by too much MDM2. There are a number of drug candidates under investigation to tackle both of these strategies, but none of these are likely to solve the entire problem. Instead, combining P53 restoration or reactivation with traditional cancer treatments is likely to pack the most powerful punch. So-called combination therapy would involve a cancer-fighting super duo, providing functional P53 in cancer cells and then hitting them with chemo or immunotherapy, destroying the cancer cells once and for all.